up third place today, Max Biaggi. Second place up crowd in the Yamaha, Troy Corsa. I'm not sure whether you've waited a longer time than him for this or whether he's waited a long time, but I'm sure it means an awful lot to him. Ladies and gentlemen, our race winner, James Toseland! Right, we're going to start off with Max. Yesterday you told us that Brands Hatch is a special place. You said Laguna Seca is strange and difficult. Brands Hatch, you said, is what?
Almost impossible. This track, when you never rode here, is unbelievable. It's not scary, but almost. So many blind corner and off camber corner, up and down, big compression, bumpy, everything. We got everything here. So I think it's the most difficult track I ever rode.
Now, you said first time racing here, and when I asked you yesterday if it's hot and you're going to get tired, you said, no, I want the second race because I still need to learn the track. Still correct?
Yeah, of course. For me, more practice, more laps, it means more confidence and maybe more chance. Anyway, for sure I want to congratulate to James and Troy. They make great race and very good rhythm. But I think my third place was also a little bit lucky, but then I got the podium. I'm very happy.
On the cool-down lap, how aware were you of all the fantastic fans here at Brands Hatch?
Yeah, amazing. So many people, so many crowd, and, you know, it looks like people enjoy so much to see this race. Of course, if I was a spectator, I was here to watch this kind of race. It's fantastic. And hopefully race two would be the same, many overtake and nice race. Hope you enjoy and see you later.
And we had better weather than Misano.
I think so.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, Max Biaggi. Lost any weight out there?
It's got to be one of the hottest races we've had, I think, this year. It's very humid. But I think the pace, you know, I think this track works you so hard. There's no rest around here, and I think that's probably part of it too.
How much of a pleasure is it to be back on the podium after the least recent run of, you know, a few problems, a little bit of bad luck here and there? Was your confidence going at all?
No, not at all. We've been having a few small problems. It's sort of just been affecting us in the race situation. In practice and qualifiers, all been good. We've done a good race distance, and then in the race, we just don't seem to be able to do it again. So, but today felt good. Morning warm-up went well, and we made a few small changes for the first race. And the bike's working really good now. It's just the tyres, but I think everyone was struggling a bit towards the end there. But really happy to first time here on the Yamaha to get a podium.
Is it the heat today, or just the actual nature of the track, or just a combination of both?
I think it's a bit of a combination of both. Like I said, around here you use a lot of on the side of the tyre for a long time. When the temperature goes up, we lose a bit of side grip a little bit. So, and the more you spin it, the hotter it gets. So. It's a no-win situation, really. We're trying to get the best we can out of the tyre and save it. But like I said, the Yamaha's working good. I've got to thank my guys. They've done a fantastic job, and hope we can go one better in the next one.
Ladies and gentlemen, Troy Corsa. What are you doing right down there?
I've come down a bit, I'm tired. It's about bloody time, isn't it? Sorry about a 10-year wait.
You know, elephants give birth quicker than it takes you to win a race around here.
Probably. I've up in close, I've had second and thirds, but there ain't nothing like winning around here. And those last five laps were difficult to concentrate on. Doing the consistent lap times, but thinking I'm going to win at Brands Hatch was difficult. But yeah, we got it across the line. Troy was putting up a big fight there, and unfortunately made a mistake, but You know, fair play to Max Biaggi, your first time at Brands Hatch on the podium. That's no mean feat, so congratulations to him. And Troy, he should be there weekend in, weekend out, and he's had a few problems this year, like was just said, but it's nice to see him back on top, because a double world champion deserves to be on the podium, and it's just great to be up there with them all, with Troy Corsa and Biaggi and Bayliss, and you know, it's done my riding a world of good since I've been in this Superbike Championship, and I wouldn't be as fast as I am today if it wasn't trying to beat these guys, and it's been a great championship for me, and I know you know there's an announcement for next year, but I wanted to prove today that winning this World Superbike Championship means more to me than going to the MotoGP next year, and this one's for my team who's worked so hard for this 2 years, and I wish them all the best in the future.
When the national anthem was playing, was that sweat dribbling down your eyes?
It was a better version than mine.
it looked pretty emotional on the TV screen.
It is, but we're not finished yet. We've got another one to go, and so the emotions can come after the second race, and I'll be a damn sight cooler, because if I get another win, then I'm chucking the leathers in, so I'll be a bit cooler up here.
I hope you're wearing your lucky Union Jack underpants.
Put some clean ones on for you, don't we?
Ladies and gentlemen, let's keep it for the second race, and let's wish you all the best. Ladies and gentlemen, our race winner, James Toseland. Second place, Troy Corsa. Fourth place, Max Biaggi. And